calling this game, Roy. It's called Hired or Fired. We're going to go through each of these resumes. So we got a long list of resumes. I'm going to go through each of them. And on each one, we're going to let you know what job they're applying for. And if you would hire them or fire them. Well, technically, it's they don't have the job, so you won't be actually firing them.
So I'm like the HR person.
Exactly. Yeah. HR Roy Wood Jr. Exactly.
Exactly. Exactly.
So we'll go through each resume, and you let us know what you think. We'll read them out to you. We'll talk about them, discuss a little bit, and see if the person is a fit or not.
Okay.
All right?
Yeah.
Cool. All right, we'll move into our... oh, my God. We have a little graphic here for you, too.
Nice.
Shout out Ian made this great animation for us.
Nice, razzle dazzle.
Right, yeah, you know, that's show business, baby.
That's it.
But, okay, this is our first resume. We'll read it off. You know, we blocked off everyone's names. I think this one came blocked off. But starts out, hashtag ready to work. Under work experience, they have retail associate, and it just says was TJ Maxx and 1 year afternoon Walgreens, January 2020 to March 2020. Under that, it literally says nothing. And then retail sales associate at another Walgreens from June 2019 to June 2019. And then under that, it says it's a work experience thing to teach how to be on time and management skills to be a better experience. Under education, it says still in high school. And their skills, retail sales, customer service, merchandising, retail sales, again, commercial cleaning, Microsoft Office, cash handling.
And this is for the job of a sales associate, by the way.
Yes.
Yes. So retail sales associate.
And don't worry, under certifications, it says ID card. So.
And we have no references on this resume.
None whatsoever.
No references alluded to. No.
Yeah, this is it. Chat, let us know in the chat also if you would hire this person.
So the high school thing is very telling. You're supposed to have a bunch of different jobs in high school. You worked at Walgreens for a month in June of 2019, which tells me you found something more interesting to do. You said F that. And you went out and had a good time in 2019. Then your money starts drying up. So January 2020, you go back and get another job, and then COVID hits, so because I'm assuming that's where the March 2020, that's why the employment ceased. Mm-hmm. But what have you been doing for the last year?
That's the question. That's the question here.
No grind? No self-start? Where's your pivot?
Exactly. A hobby?
Nothing?
Something?
You're not even qualified to do TikTok. Nothing? Fire.
Fired.
Ooh, fire.
Boom.
Game on. And we even got a graphic
for it.
There we
go. Yeah, we got a graphic for everything.
Nice, a step.
Fired.
Hit it again, Ian. Fire the ass again.
Fired. That is a lazy 2020 right there.
Exactly. They were chilling.
Right. They were hanging out, not doing much. Worked at the Walgreens for a month. Called it a 2019. 2019, good year to have fun, though. I will give them that. Good year to just get out there.
Hang on.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Am I being mean? Because everybody had a different pandemic, and some people may have suffered
a lot. You know, that's a point. That's a good point.
That's
a good point.
Perhaps this is this person's...
But what about the fact that there's... what about the resume itself, you know? Right. Even if the years weren't 2020
All they know is Microsoft Word.
And...
what else was it?
Retail, sales, customer service, merchandising.
And cash handling. Very important. Can handle cash.
First off, if all you know is Microsoft Word, you're a liar, which means you don't know Microsoft Word, because it's impossible to learn Microsoft Word, not residually pick up some PowerPoint and some Excel. Lie.
Right.
Lie.
That is true. Not even Microsoft Suite.
No, I stand on it. Fired.
Still fired.
Still fired. Okay. Still fired.
Boom.
Very good.
I agree. Ooh, I'm excited for this next one.
So we're going to move on to our next one over here. Text is a little small.
Oh, my God. Fired.
Give him a chance. Give Ricky a chance. So I'm going to read this
give
one off to you.
Give Leatherface a chance.
So this guy's name is Ricky. He's actually... So maybe in this case, he's auditioning to be an actor. He's auditioning for a lead role in your latest show, possibly, right? So
he looked like he auditioning to be the Joker. This town deserves a better class of criminal.
So, okay, here's his resume. Ricky's seen it all. Everything from being born in the middle of a tornado and given a 75% chance to live to running with the biggest rock stars of the 80s. Ricky knows how to go big, but why not let Ricky tell the story himself? Now, quote from Ricky. Hey guys, Ricky here. I've done some crazy shit, man. It has forged me into the man I am today. You need a dude that got what it takes to let's make it happen. And that's a fur quote, let's make it happen. Woo woo. You need experience, 6 years tour manager for Jigales, 3 years of security for Leadfoot, okay. 4 year guitar tech for one word, white fucking snake, followed by 2 years in jail, then followed again by 3 more years, personal helper to David Coverdale. I made it big with music and now I'm ready for movies. I could read the last paragraph if you want to hear more, but if you've already made your decision, let us know, but I can go on.
No, give me a little bit more.
Okay. There's more. If you take on Ricky, capitalized underlined, as a client, you will get paid. You will get paid for taking on Ricky. Need more proof? Here's a quote from Ricky to Jake. Not sure who Jake is. I'm going to fucking destroy the movie world. And then Jake said back, move over, Tom Cruise. Time for the new fucking blood. If you don't call up Ricky Santangelo now, someone else will. And, oh, wait, what does that say? And your boss will fucking fire you for fucking up. Please, I don't got a phone right now, so email me. My email's on the right side of this page. Signed, Ricky, and it's a picture of a guitar.
Hired.
Wow, see, look at that.
Hired.
And it's my fault for racially profiling that white man and not looking at his qualifications and instead disqualifying him solely for looking wild as hell in a photograph.
Oh,
here's why we hired this gentleman.
Oh my gosh.
I've worked the road.
That was great. Yeah, no, Ricky.
And he was security, right? I want to make sure I'm getting these qualifications right. He was security for White Snake.
Is that what he said?
And I believe he was a guitar tech.
Four years guitar tech for Whitesnake. Yes.
Okay, go back to the security. He was a security guard and he did tour management, right?
Yes. Yes.
There's nothing more unpredictable.
3 years security, 4 years guitar tech, followed by 2 years in jail.
Let's not worry about jail.
And three years as a personal helper to David Coverdale.
When you are working on the road, you have to wear multiple hats. You have to be a team player. If you are the weak link, you will get exposed fast on a tour and you will not last 3 years doing that job. It is a million different variables. It is, when I talk about people skills, you need people skills to do that type of job. And to be cooped up a guitar tech, I don't know what that is. I don't know enough about that side of like music road stuff, but it sounds like you're in charge of the guitars, which are an important part of the broadcast.
That's true.
You're essentially the hand of the king. If this guitar don't work, the show don't rock, and we don't sell no tickets, and we all broke. But he was a guitar tech for a long ass time. I fucking like Ricky.
Look at that.
To jail, shit happens. It's the road. There's lots of drugs. You probably punch somebody. Whatever. And if you went to jail for 2 years, I know it's not for anything that I would deem morally irredeemable. What do you go to jail for 2 years? More often than not, it's for punching somebody you wasn't supposed to punch. They didn't die, and it wasn't severe. It wasn't a severe injury because it's under 5 years sentencing. So it's probably a property crime or some possession of something that should be legal in the first place. So I'm okay with the going to jail.
Okay. He's hired.
Yeah.
Ricky is hired.
Hiring Ricky.
Completely hired. Resounding.
Yeah, I feel like you two don't agree with my choice.
No.
I'm feeling so.
I think I do agree with your choice, actually.
You wouldn't hire Ricky.
No.
It was the picture. I was the same reaction you were with the picture. That's what it was for me. It's nothing else about Ricky. It's just the photo. But he seems like he's lived
a life. Say what you will about the photo. Say what you will about the appearance. But the man knows how to write a resume.
He got our attention. It was, and the first line of it says, get ready to be blown away by Ricky. Yeah. And we were. So.
And the first line is, the first paragraph is so impressive to me because it's a narrator talking, and then it says, well, don't believe me, here's Ricky himself. And the next paragraph is Ricky talking. It's beautifully constructed in every exactly. single way.
It's great. Ricky, if you're out there, I have a job for you somewhere on one of my shows.
Exactly. We'll get you in contact with them.
Well, I mean, you don't have That's a phone, right. so you probably can't hit me. But when you get a phone, right. Ricky.
He has an email address. Yeah.
Exactly. We'll put you in contact. We'll put you
in contact.
Fair enough.
All right.
Corey Zek, thank you for subscribing.
Hey, thank you for the subscriptions, Corey Zek. And sorry to everybody for me mispronouncing that. What
Jay
is
Giles.
That? Jay Giles. Okay. What did I say? Jay Gales?
Jiggles.
Jiggles.
I don't even remember. Things happen Jiggles? And I just immediately forget
Jay
them.
Giles. It is Jay Giles. Sorry, everybody. We go to the next slide
yeah.
here.
Yeah. So we have this lovely resume.
Yes. Now we have this other resume. And
it's too long.
It's yes, it's very long. So this is an application, a resume submitted for the application of a personal assistant on your Comedy Central sitcom, Roy.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. A personal assistant. Mm-hmm. So we have here, let me pull up the images.
Yes.
Okay. So education, George Washington University School of Media and Public Affairs, GPA 3.4.
Nice.
Relevant coursework includes news writing, reporting, communications, public communications, interpersonal communications, strategic communications, a lot of communications, stage acting, U.S. and world history, and Spanish. George Washington University Colonial Inauguration 2014 booked and ran the entire freshman orientation Ooh. Program with a team of fellow students.
Got an overachiever over here.
So media and communications experience, social media intern for foodiesandfatties.com, Washington, D.C., December 2013 to January.
Wait, what?
What is that?
Foodies or fatties?
Foodiesandfatties.com. That's the name of the website.
Okay.
From December 2013 to January 2014. And managed the website's social media presence, created tweets and Facebook posts, modernized the website's approach to social media advertising.
Wait, I just want to say I went to that website while you were reading it.
Yes.
Wish that I had it.
Does it not exist?
Immediately closed out. Something very weird came up. And I'm God. just all of these
okay.
letters.
So it's porn.
It's definitely porn.
So it's some fetish porn. So it's...
food porn.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Full figure and food porn.
Keep in mind also, that's from December 2013 to January 2014, which is 1 month. 1 month. Collectively. George Washington University Television. Edit video for show using editing software. Operate video cameras and assist with video production. We'll talk. Okay, we'll skip a little bit. This is a really long resume.
Someone in the chat said, we don't hire nerds. Sorry.
I was thinking that, but I was trying to think of a nicer way to say it. But the foodies and fatties kind of redeems them in a way because there's a lot of, you know, a lot of brainiac curriculum and high GPA, but then you went to work for a porn site. Keep going.
Right. Okay. So George Washington University, WRGW radio station, host of weekly radio show, working title, research and assistant with on-air interviews, including members of the band Coheed and Cambria. Okay. Extracurricular activities, a cappella group marketing chair, student theater, all the roles that this person has ever been in student theater are
wow.
listed.
A lot of lead roles
up
though.
To this point onto theater. The next page, a lot of lead roles, a lot of big time yeah. acting jobs.
I've never heard of any of these plays.
Theater department, also another role listed. Skills, proficient in PowerPoint, Excel, Word, parentheses, Microsoft Office.
Nice.
Proficient in social media advertising with Hootsuite, Facebook, and Twitter. And personal information, performed in a band, writing songs, singing, playing guitar, bass, and drums, managing band finances, and social media performance efforts. And final bullet on the entire resume, captain of high school varsity tennis team 2012.
Hey. Fired.
Fired.
Why?
Fired.
Do you have a why?
There's too much going on. Yeah. Doesn't know what he wants to do with his life.
It's a very long resume.
It is a really long resume.
And I understand that if he's applying to just be a PA, you're not going to be a PA for long because that resume reads like someone with a lot of ambition, but not sure where their true north is. So they're still trying to find themselves, which I respect.
Mm-hmm.
I respect mm-hmm. you dabbling in the foodie porn website. I, you know, Okay. Worth, you know, I don't know if you get an employee discount. I don't know if he was already into that.
10% off.
Where do porn sites even put their job listings? How did you, anyway?
How does anybody find work on
like
porn sites?
Is there like a jobs page?
Yeah. I hear they treat their employees very well.
I bet they do. Yeah.
So I don't know. Yeah.
Wait, I don't know. I've never seen that on monster.com. I would have.
Or Indeed or anything like that.
LinkedIn.
I got a LinkedIn message from a porn company.
Oh, you did?
Really?
Yeah. Wow. Oh, my God.
Ian's like, so I will be leaving next week to work for Pornhub.
If the pay is good.
If Pornhub was hiring for social media intern, I would apply.
Yeah, I would definitely apply.
The social media person there actually does interviews. She's like a popular social media person. Oh, yeah, she seems to be living a great life.
Apparently, they treat their employees very well over there.
Yeah.
Here's the issue that I think you find in entertainment is that if you hire someone for behind the camera work who eventually is showing desires and tendencies to be in front of the camera, you're better off trying to hire them for something where they really want to be. Because in the long run, you're going to make me weaker because you're going to do this as long as you can. Then you're going to go start your band or you're going to go and do your theater or whatever. It's a lot of in front of the camera stuff. You're applying for a behind the camera job. So if I had two applicants of equal capabilities and degrees and equal nerd, the one that is showing a more clear and definitive desire to work behind the camera, that's who I'm gonna hire, because you're going to have more focus and more investment in what's happening here.
Right.
Band theater porn person is going to be up and gone in 6 months, and then I'm gonna have to replace the position anyway, which leaves me at a deficit. So if this it's two true. Candidates of equal resume, whatever the fuck, I'm gonna hire the person who really wants to be in this field and in this world, because I know there's gonna mean more to them and I know they're gonna work hard. What happens if I hire band theater nerd and then you porn comes a knocking? Huh?
Oh,
then what?
They're going straight off to you porn. I guarantee it. Huh? Guaranteed.
When Bang Bus calls them up and says, "Hey, you wanna be a driver for Bang?" Not that I've ever been to Bang Bus.
That's a deep cut.
Very specific. You're learning a lot about Roy today.
Come on, Mr. Marcus. Send your email. What's up, dog? Come work with Mr. Marcus.
Oh my God. Well, Roy.
That's like an older civil right. He's a porn star from the civil rights era. I know the young people on Twitch don't know about Mr. Marcus.
Wait. So, Roy, you're saying this person wouldn't work well behind the camera. Do you think they should be in front of the camera?
Yes. So I would try to hire them for something. Like that's the type of person I would call in and then offer them something different if I had something. Hey, why don't you shadow the actor or something? Because it's clear from this resume that you're doing everything, but what do you want to do? And I understand you do everything to learn everything, but sooner or later, you have to narrow your focus. So that's what I would challenge this person to do. Mm-hmm. And the resume starts out with all this behind the camera shit, but the longer you get into like later and later into their work history, it's all in front of the camera stuff.
Well, what if I told you they are in front of the camera?
It's Jon.
It's my resume.
The break, look at his resume.
That proves it then.
Yeah, you were right.
I mean, you were right.
Because No.
You were taking sexy
completely.
Yeah. What's
laser
the website?
Beam photos.
What is that website? Because seriously,
Okay. So this is my resume from 2014 when I was applying to internships. I was still in school. Again, like completely accurate, the things you were saying, like big nerd, I still am, don't know what I want to do, have a lot of things that I've tried, but nothing that I've kind of directly zeroed in on. And that makes perfect sense to me. The website was a, I don't know, truthfully, I don't know really what it was. I found it on some page, on some job site. I went into it, I looked it up, I submitted an application, I got an email from some email account, and it was like, hey, you got the job. I don't know what job it was.
Wait.
It was a...
You never sent a resume, you're hired.
They were like, absolutely, like, we loved you so much. No interview, just hired me immediately. And they gave me a login to their website page that had a link out to this other platform that like had their tweets on it, and they were just like, yeah, just like retweet a couple things a day and like make a couple posts. And I did that for about 2 weeks.
What kind of posts?
Like food. It was about like food. in some capacity or another.
Okay.
Might have been porn.
What about food?
Might have been porn.
Yeah, like what type of posts were they encouraging you? Like, because I understand the food part, but you have to get to the and part.
Yeah, wait, what was that about? It was foodies
and fatties. Yeah, it was what I was doing really for them was a lot of product posts. It was like, so nothing like... Nothing like the imagery wasn't wild or anything. They were just like, yeah, put this pan up there. I think it was like a food blog with like an edgy name at the end of the day.
Okay.
So I don't think it was actually like anything like that going on, but it could have been. I wouldn't have known about it.
What a time to be alive.
Right.
And you could just say those words and that's your URL too. Like not like you tweeted. Yeah. Yeah. No. Nothing wrong with that.
Oh my gosh, that's great.
But yes, resume and like a circa.
So you're in front of the camera now. So that's where you want to be.
That's where I want to be.
That's the truth.
That's what I worked out. So
by doing all that stuff behind the camera, you start learning everything, man. Mm-hmm. You learn everything. And then you zeroed in. So now you do this, and then I'll come hire you when I have some budget, when one of these sitcoms gets greenlit.
Fantastic. There we go. Wow.
Look at that. What a lovely full circle moment.
Well, this might backfire on us a little bit. We don't want to lose you, Jon.
Then we're like, Jon is no longer with us next week.
There was just something about that resume where I just go, this person is doing a lot. But
that was spot on.
Yeah,
that
no, very spot on.
Spot
very
on. Spot the whole on. Time you were talking, I was like, go on. Mm-hmm. In front of the camera, you say.
Well,
that's great.
I wonder what Brazzers would pay somebody to run their social.
Listen, go ahead and look it up.
They apparently pay pretty well. I feel like they offered to buy an entire stadium in Australia recently and rename it. I think it was like supposed to rename it the Bang Bros Stadium in Australia. And it didn't go. They didn't accept, but they had the money for it. They offered up the money. So, I mean, huge.
Nice.
Huge. It's possible.
But anyways, we can move up into our next resume over here.
Yeah, we might only have time for...
Oh, wow. Oh, my God. Look at this time.
I know. Should we wait? So much fun.
Should we do this? Is there another one we should do?
Yes. I think there's another one we should do. Yes. Man. Yeah.
Skip by the...
Okay.
I know. I
if we have time, we'll get to that one because that one's very important. But this one has a lot of importance. So
another long one.
Yeah.
This one is for an editorial intern at Rolling Stone right here.
Yeah.
Tia, do you want to read it off?
Oh, yeah. I can read it. Okay, so the person went to University of Delaware, majored in communications, minored in criminal justice. They listed out all of their high school courses by what type they were, advanced AP and also gifted and talented courses, English, history, blah, 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 notable electives. Here's their volunteer experience and work experience. They worked at a concert venue where they interacted with various customers and individuals, prepared food items quickly and efficiently, had inventory, worked at an Italian ice shop, maintained and restocked inventory, completed monetary transactions. They volunteered at the library.
A lot of fancy words in there.
about like the most basic.
Monetary transactions.
They just freaking rang people up. That's all it was.
That's what I need in my employee.
They volunteered at the library. I don't really know how complicated that could be, but they have four bullet points for it, including utilize computer skills to register library patrons for library programs. They also listed all of their school activities on the side. Varsity lacrosse, 3 years, member of the National Honor Society, Make-A-Wish Club, literary magazine, newspaper reporter. Under skills, they wrote, type 100 words per minute.
Caseman 984, thank you for subscribing with Pine.
Oh, hey.
Thanks for the subscription.
Thanks for the sub. Nice.
Must love the resume.
Thanks for I know. They're giving it a hired. Proficient in Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and the internet. Proficient in Windows and Mac platforms. Excellent communication skills, excellent customer service skills. I guess we're taking their word for it, but
100 words per?
100 words per
strike
minute.
Strike one.
You think it's a lie? You don't think they can?
Strike one.
100 words per minute. Yeah, that's a lot.
That fast or slow?
I think that's very fast. I type like
when did you when did you when did you learn 100 words per minute? When you were reshelving books at the library or when you were conducting monetary nacho transference over the concession counter at the concert venue.
Valid point. When do you have the time to learn typing?
I don't know. I mean, they have some. I don't know.
Is there GPA on this resume? I can't see it from.
No, it is not. Just a list of their high school courses and their major and minor from their.
All right, so we're dealing with a C student. We're dealing with a C student. nobody's coming under with all of that talented and gifted gibberish without bragging about it. If your GPA is over a 3.3, if it's over a 3, you're putting it on a resume. Especially
that's fair.
With an experience pool that shallow.
That makes
sense. So you're a C student, and I know C students when I see them because your font size is too big and you juiced up the font spacing between every line. You went 12 font with 14 font spacing. You think I'm fucking stupid, but I'm not. I'm not. Look at that spacing. You telling me everything on this resume couldn't have been crunched?
It's a lot of spaces.
They added extra words and verbiage and gibberish. You could have two-column half of those bullet points.
Monetary transactions.
You're a liar. You're a liar, but I'm going to hire you.
Oh, hired.
Why hired?
Here's why I'm going to hire you. Because lying to get the job shows ambition. It shows that you really believe in yourself, and I haven't done enough, but I gotta make what I've done look like it's enough.
Yeah.
So let me stretch it out. And I, you know, as a person who humbly graduated from college with a 2.7, nothing wrong with making C's. Sometimes you just got shit to do. I ain't got time to learn everything. How much I need to learn to not take this class again? That's what I'm gonna learn.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm
gonna
see you later. So, you know, this person, I got to get to the library, man. I can't show up for this midterm. Kiss my ass. So maybe that's what this person is. So, yeah, I would hire this person, but watch them. They can type 100 words and then.
Yeah, first, that's the first test. They come on, you watch them like
a
hawk.
Type words
see if they can type those 100 words per minute like they claim.
Well,
yeah.
Uh-huh. Roy, this is my resume from like freshman year of college. And you know what?
So,
my mom.
First question.
Yes. Wait, no. You go.
Were you a C student in high school?
I actually wasn't, because two things. One, I doctored this a little bit because I'm extremely paranoid. So I took out experience that were super specific to me. But I never put my resume on my, I don't remember what my GPA was. But I definitely added big words to make it sound like I did more than I did. And I added 100 words per minute because my mom, who is watching and in the chat, told me to put 100 words per minute on my resume because she was like, people like that. It makes you, and I can type very fast.
So my mother was a keyboard instructor.
Oh, wow.
Before she went to higher education.
Call me out.
Man.
And so we had to do the words per minute test or whatever. I was averaging like 65 with errors. And I think my mom was doing 85 to 90 words a minute.
The instructor of the course was doing 85 to 90.
So to be at 100, like,
I have to say, I haven't measured it recently, but I do type very fast, but I think that's just because I'm very overstimulated. So I think that's a big reason for it. Someone in the chat said, I believe that because of how fast she texts in the chat. I am like, I have little skeleton fingers, but.
That's fair.
But.
That's fair.
You know.
Well, you know what? 100 is enough to get you hired, but that's something you got to back up because that's extraordinary.
Yeah.
First day on the job. Nobody, I took it off shortly after. Just making me go
to one of those typingtest.com. There's a bunch of type test websites.
Mm-hmm.
Go
yeah.
on a typing test website.
You want me to do it right now?
I'm like 75.
Yeah, do it right now. We got a minute. Man. We got
wait,
a minute.
Do we have time? Typing
test. Share your screen again.
Wait, hold
Let's
on.
See if you
okay,
can share your
on.
Screen.
Yeah, I'm going to
oh,
be very impressed.
Oh, wait, I still have that same.
If this works out.
Hold on, I still have the same window open. Can you see it, Ian?
Do you need something to type? Like, do you
no,
need
I believe
like
it
like
got screwed up. So try unsharing and resharing.
All right, I'm going
to just show you what to type.
Yeah, it like gives you sentences, right?
Oh, it does. Okay.
Yeah, okay. Hold on. Sorry.
Oh, man.
Sharing my screen. Yeah, we'll see if I still
if
got it,
it.
I feel like I'm lucky if
I'm
I get out.
I'm going to just like throw it on top of this.
Okay, I'll do a minute typing test, medium text on typingtest.com.
This is part of the job interview. This is
okay, all
right.
Right.
Wait. Hold on. I got
my
quick.
Sleeves. Okay, let me know, Ian,
quick.
When to start. Okay. And I'll press start typing test.
Oh,
I'm
God.
Sweating a little bit.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
I'm really excited to see this. I feel like the best I could possibly do in a whole minute is maybe realistically like 40.
You think
I'm
so?
A very slow typer.
You're like
I use these fingers and nothing else.
All right, when you're
ready.
Two.
Here it goes.
Okay.
The two.
I'm ready.
Oh, there it is.
All right. Okay.
Oh
I'm going to click start. Okay.
Okay, you do move pretty quick. I gotta say.
Oh shit, you're cooking. You're
flying. Oh my god.
Oh damn it.
Oh my god.
Oh, mom's telling the truth.
Wait, isn't?
Oh my god, I got the suspenseful music on now. Oh lord. Oh my god, Tia. Jeez.
Oh no, all caps. How fast they go if nothing is blocking.
Whoa!
Oh my god.
Start. Oh, dang, now we're getting nervous. Making noises.
Tia didn't come to play.
Yes, to answer you, Android, I do type with four fingers. Exactly. Just four.
And the black bears come in just black. But surprisingly.
Oh my god. I'm never going to look at you the same way again. I hope you know
three,
that.
Just, two,
I've been on the internet too long,
one.
I have to say. All right.
What do we do?
87.
Wait, 87?
87. Still, like,
wait,
very good.
But it says typing speed 106, adjusted speed 87 based on accuracy. Woo! So, technically.
You are 100.
Technically.
Wow. Oh, all my right. God.
Let me apologize to your mom. And
she did say in the chat, though, she said, Roy Wood Jr., you are very insightful. And then she said, see, told you she's fat. See? They were alarmed about it at first.
Your mom must be so proud right now.
I know. Wow. She's like, I told you it would come in here. This is the moment. This is what you were talking about.
Right now, fist bump.
Yeah, she's like, I knew it. I knew this day would come.
Exactly. It didn't come for the job I applied for with this resume, but it came out now with this moment. So look at that.
Wow. Incredible. I am proud as hell, she says.
Whew, that was great.
That's very impressive. I'm glad I don't have to do this because I would be embarrassed. I'm probably down to 60 words per.
It's like 10. You're like, try it my best take. Here. Oh my gosh.
The more I forget my passwords, the better my typing gets because my passwords have to get crazier and crazier.
Oh my god, same. Oh geez. It's so do you have the same problem, Roy, where you just have like so many, like 80 accounts, and just like you, everyone demands a different password,
like,
and then you're
bros.
Like, I gotta do my Brazzers account is my Bang Bros account.
That's why you gotta have one porn
and
email.
I read the article about the guy who got locked out of his Bitcoin account, and he only has two more guesses before he forfeits millions of dollars.
I heard about that. That is messed up. God.
That's my biggest nightmare. It's just being locked out of something that I really need. And like,
right?
No, please.
It's like a life or death. That's why you just make your password 123 and keep it pushing. You never forget.
Of course.
Oh, my God. Well, Roy, we wanted to thank you so much for coming on the show today. We know we're running out of time, but first of all, really appreciate you being on. We had an amazing time talking with you, working through some resumes, some of our old resumes as well. And we really, really loved having you on today.
Thank you so much for joining
us
today.
Absolutely.
Yeah, please come back anytime.
Hey, and I might have to hire both of y'all away, and then I'll have the producers on job fair to talk about the two positions they're hiring for.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
Exactly. And
if it gets me on the podcast, maybe.
Yeah, right.
That's,
yeah, right.
That's okay.
Exactly. Ever need any guests? Let us know.
Right. Let us know. We got stories. I can tell some laser tag stories.
Exactly. And really quickly, before you go, can you just plug for everyone watching at home in the chat what you're working on, what you have coming up next?
So we're working on a television show with Fox right now about the National Guard and just all of the craziness that happens on the day-to-day deployments domestically, and just, you know, trying to help Americans get back to, you know, get back to their lives after whatever craziness happens. And also The Daily Show, you know, we're trying to do our thing. So every night at 11 on Comedy Central. And of course, download Roy's Job Fair podcast. And matter of fact, be a part of it if you want. Just shoot me a message. I'm around. I check all my social medias because I have no life.
Yeah. No, we would love to wait.
Do this interview in my bedroom. I don't go anywhere.
Great bed. Looks great. Really quickly, someone kept asking in the chat what the C on your hat is for. I assumed it was...
Oh, it's the Cubs.
They thought it was the Cubs.
That's what they thought, but they changed the logo. There was like a whole discussion about it in the chat, and then I saw someone drop it in again. So just to clarify, now you all know.
Yeah, baseball purists get infuriated when people like me wear weird stuff.
Well, now they know. But thank you so much again, Roy, for joining us on the stream. This has been great.
All right.
Bye.
Thanks, Roy. Bye.